Hello and welcome to Ghana's official high school TV channel, High School Plug TV, broadcasting from our studio. A year ago, the Ministry of Education introduced a STEM competition called STEMnovation. The purpose of this competition was to challenge and aid students to become problem solvers in the country. The race for this year's STEMnovation has begun. Many thanks to our supporter, Brunswick. They are producers of nutritious and delicious tuna flakes that comes in various varieties of your form. We'll go for a quick commercial break. When we return, I'll introduce my guest to you. Do stay with us.
Why all the excitement about Brunswick chunk tuna and water? It contains no preservatives, no additives. It's wild-caught tuna for a healthy lifestyle. And being so healthy, it could practically be in a different section of the store. Brunswick chunk tuna and water. No additives, no preservatives, pure health.
Welcome back from the break. This is High School Plug TV. My name is Nana Echamio. You know, even from the beginning, God created and things came into being. That means that in everything, there's a creator and a creature. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with the deputy coordinator for Free Senior High School and the brain behind STEMnovation, Miss Sika Afra Mensah. Hello.
Hi, Echa.
How are you? Looking beautiful as always. Thank you. I'm fine. Okay. You look nice.
Thank you.
What an innovation. Last year, it was a talk of town. We saw mind-blowing projects. What do you think STEMnovation is here to solve? What problem? And why target senior high school students?
Okay. Myself and the hard-working team, we realized that looking at the investment government is popping into the free senior high school space, it's not always about the chew, pour, write, and forget. We wanted to challenge the student to bring something practical on the table. Yeah. That is why we brought the STEMnovation on the table. Minister was always preaching about STEM, but the innovation bit was missing. So we thought it wise that we wanted to bring something like a practical-based competition among the senior high school, since we already have the theory one, which is the science and math quiz. That is why we brought the STEMnovation thing on the table to challenge the senior high school students to bring something innovative, to bring something creative, something that is able to solve issue within their community. So we gave them three things for them to identify a problem within their community and find solutions to solve it.
That is great. Well, we are done with the roadshow for this year's STEMnovation. Personally, I was at Kumasi, Cape Coast, and then Accra. I saw how beautiful the whole thing was. What do you have to say about the roadshow, even though you are not yet at the finale?
The roadshow was mind-blowing and it was amazing. Looking at the projects these students developed and exhibited at the roadshow, myself, I looked down, I sit back and realized that, wow, these Ghanaian students are very creative.
Yes.
If students at this level can be such an innovative, then I think we need to push them to do more. So the roadshow was mind-blowing. Mm-hmm. I think that's what I can say. It was mind-blowing and it was great.
Was it challenging?
No, financially it was, but I think in all we have to give thanks to God.
How about compiling of the schools? You know, I think at Kumasi we had Bunu East, some schools from the Bunu side to come, and then Cape Coast, we had schools from Western. And how was it like, you know, getting all of these schools together, making sure they were all there to pitch their projects?
Even tell them to register is not even a small job. You need to call them, frequent calls every day on them. Though there's an upcoming competition coming up, please register. But thanks to the heads and the hardworking teachers, we were able to get an appreciable number of schools to come on board to register for the competition. So I think, you know, zoning them wasn't a big challenge, but how to commute them from their community to the zonal center was a big challenge. But at the end of the day, whatever issue it is, positive outweighs the negatives that we face in every competition. So I think it was a success.
And I think last year was the maiden edition, so as it keeps on going, it becomes more tough and challenging. So I just think it's all part of the program.
Absolutely.
Next month is the finale. Yes. What is the future of STEMnovation 2023 grand finale?
It's going to be great, because looking at the issue, the problems that students have identified, and they are able to solve those challenges that they are facing within their community. When I sit back, I realize that Ghana, we have a future. Because if students are able to solve issues within their community, at the end of the day, we wouldn't even wait for foreigners to come and solve our own issues for us. Yes. But we will sit down and identify a problem within our community, and we will solve the problem within the community, and it will extend to the national challenges that we are facing. So STEMnovation has come to stay, and we are here to solve issues of national interest.
STEMnovation has indeed come to stay, and then we are going to solve issues of national interest. We'll go for a quick commercial break. We'll be right back. It is the Zonals for this year's STEMnovation.
We are pitching sustainable gardening using plastic bottles just to reduce the escalating crisis of plastic waste in our urban areas.
This year's STEMnovation came with the theme flexible electricity supply, water purification and urban garden. But we focus on urban garden as a result of food scarcity there and then land scarcity. So we've designed an innovation based at the stage to identifying solutions of food scarcity and techniques to tackle the issues effectively in our urban cities.
Our project is on urban garden, that's our project area, and the title of our project is automated irrigation for a backyard garden. So this project focuses on solving the problem of people not having small gardens in their home so that they could plant certain crops.
Okay, so this year our project is mainly centered on making use of the little spaces around us to just produce some food for people to consume, because agriculture is not really, it's not getting there for us. We want to add something to complement it.
Our project is about generating electricity with dirty water as a result of illegal mining, and using a purifier to filter out the dirt and use this water for domestic use.
We brought a mechanized small-scale irrigation system for urban garden. That is, it looks like a bed, a farm bed, where we have various structures for growing of crops. So everyone in urban areas can equally grow crops and really benefit more here.
Welcome back from that breather. I'm still here with Miss Afra. We are just talking about STEMnovation, how important it is that schools get involved into this great initiative. Miss Afra, one key thing that I've noticed about the Minister of Education is that he's really passionate about STEM. Yes, and then I had an interaction with some girls from Busumtree Girls STEM Senior High, and you could see how delighted and happy that they were given such an opportunity to study these real things in STEM. I mean,
you can't pull this just by yourself. I'm sure you have stakeholders, sponsors, supporters, hardworking team behind you to champion this cause. What would you say to them?
I have a fantastic team. 24/7, they are always there. We don't sleep. We are always working. But this year, we are in partnership with NEIP.
Okay.
So we have a lot of innovation hubs across the country that students can go there and upgrade their projects and everything. So NEIP has come on board, GOL, Ghana Gas, there are lots of sponsors.
Wow.
I will share their names with you so that after this interview, you will just add them to whatever we are doing. So STEMnovation is a big deal now.
It's a big deal.
Nah, so please, I want everybody to come on board. Okay. We need a lot of investors to come on board, because looking at the project, it's very innovative. So we needed a lot of people to come so that we will expand it to commercialization and every the ideation stage that these students have brought on board. We needed to commercialize some of these projects so that at the end of the day, issues with national interest will be resolved.
Speaking of commercials, mostly when we know someone wins a competition, they just get the prize fund. If they have to travel, they travel, return to their country, and we don't really hear of them and their projects again. So how different is STEMnovation? Are we actually going to see these projects from the various schools in motion in the near future?
That is why when you were there last year to witness the RARA competition, they are resolving problems within their community. If
amazing.
A student will sit down and realize that there's an issue within a community in my region, that teachers and nurses are not accepting postings to those communities. So let me find a remedy to this solution. And students were able to develop rural electrification to resolve issues within their community. It means that STEM Innovation is doing more good.
Yes.
We are resolving issues of national interest. So we are not, it's not what makes our competition unique or different from other competitions is that our competition is there to resolve societal problems. It's not just a competition. So I told you NEIP are partnering with us this year so that after all said and done, after all the projects has come, after they have taken whatever awards that they've taken from it, they need to visit all the innovation hubs across the 16 region just to upgrade their projects.
Wow.
So it's not just a project that they are developing so that at the end of the day, the project will be sitting on a desk. But the project we are looking or we are seeing to it that it will be commercialized at the end of the day.
That is amazing. That's
absolutely
really amazing.
A charm.
Ms. Afra, this year, what areas are we looking at?
This year, we are looking at clean water, urban gardening, and then flexible use of electricity.
Sounds interesting.
Amazing.
Well, viewers at home, I'm here with Ms. Afra. We're talking about STEM innovation. Just like she said, it's a very great and innovative competition, and High School Plug, we are really, really excited to partner and be part of this initiative. Thank you so much for joining me here.
Thank you so much for having me.
It was so fun having you in the studio.
Sure,
and
sure,
thank
sure,
you so
sure.
Much for your time.
It was amazing.
So
thank you.
So watch out for STEM Innovation. I mean, the grand finale next month. It starts on the 7th and then ends on the 9th of November. Who wins? I mean, I can't wait to find out the school that
we will get
is
there.
Going to win. All of this we brought to you right here on High School Plug TV. Thank you so much. My name is Nane Chano. Don't forget to follow us on all social media platforms, on Instagram, Facebook, and on YouTube. It is High School Plug TV. Many thanks to our supporter, Brunswick Ghana. So, thank you so much.
What's up, people? This is Rodalo Boy Kwakudale team. Keep watching High School Plug.
High School Plug.
High School Plug.
High School Plug.
Entertainment, campus lifestyle, talent exposure, bringing you trending news on all high school events and your juicy high school's favorite music video.
After the fun, there's books, but after the books, there's fun again. So.
Nero Nisi Optima.
Only the best.
Mary's
Overwhelmed.
Akraka
Blow.
Hashtag
Identify.
Keep watching.